Okay, so as we are going to start with the problems on trusses, in the introduction we just studied that in trusses, that is analysis of trusses, basically we find out two important things. One is the reactions in place of supports, and the second thing is about the member forces. Okay. Now, in today's class, we shall study how to calculate the reactions. Now, we have discussed on how to calculate the reactions for beams. The same way we are going to calculate the reactions for trusses also. So there is no much difference between beams and truss. So both are structural members. Both are structures. So we are going to calculate. We are going to calculate the reaction first. Okay. Now, in the present question, if you see, you have a truss, wherein you have two point loads which are acting at point B and at point D. Okay, and you are supposed to calculate the reactions at A and C, wherein you can find that at point A you have a hinged support and you have a roller support at point C. Okay, yes. So the notations, that is RA and RC, they are the reactions at A and C. So we shall just assume the reactions to be acting upwards. So let this be RA. So you have RA which is acting upwards. Similarly, you have RC which is acting upwards as well. Also, you have one more horizontal reaction here. So since hinge has two reactions, you need to give a horizontal reaction also. So let us assume the reaction to act leftwards. Like this. So let this be the horizontal reaction at A. So this is just an assumption. And based on the answers what we get, we will calculate or we will find out whether the directions which are assumed are positive or correct or not. Yes. So we all know that we have three equations of equilibrium which we can make use of. So the first equation which we shall use is the moment itself. So we shall take moment at point A. Okay. Now, when you take moment at point A, the first thing is you are supposed to count the total number of forces. Next, you are supposed to see how many forces passes through moment center. Finally, conclude with how many components you are going to have in the moment equation. So if you count the number of forces, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you have total of 5 forces. In which 1 and 2, they pass through moment center A. Therefore, you are left with only 3 forces. So you are going to have 3 components in the moment equation. Now, let us start with the components. The first one, reaction at C. We all know that reaction at C is a vertical force. So distance to be multiplied is horizontal, and it is acting at a distance of 4 meter from A and causing a anti-clockwise rotation. Thereby, we write it with the negative sign, that is minus RC into 4. Similarly, you have the next force, that is 8 kilonewton. Now this 8 kilonewton force is a horizontal force, and the distance to be multiplied is vertical distance. So it is 8 into 1.5. It is causing a clockwise rotation. It is causing a clockwise rotation. Thereby, it is written with the positive sign. That is 8 into 1.5. Finally, you have a 12 kilonewton force. A 12 kilonewton force, wherein it is a vertical force. So distance to be multiplied is obviously horizontal distance, and it is acting at a distance of 2 meters from A, thereby causing a clockwise rotation. Clockwise rotation. Hence, it is again written with the positive sign. That is 12 into 2. So you have got the equation for movement. That is MA is equal to minus RC into 4 plus 8 into 1.5 plus 12 into 2. After rearranging the terms in this, you will get RC into 4 is equal to 8 into 1.5 plus 12 into 2, which is 36. So RC is 36 by 4, which is 9 kilonewton. So you have got the reaction at C, RC, that is 9 kilonewton. Now, next, let us apply one more equation of equilibrium, that is sigma fx or sigma fy, what you call sigma fy. So total, how many vertical forces are there? Total, how many vertical forces are there? 1, 2, 3 vertical forces. Three vertical forces in which both the reactions are positive. This point load is negative. This point load is negative. Okay. So you have both the reactions positive and 12 kilonewton negative. Thereby, you can write this equation as Fy is equal to 0. So you have reaction at A positive. You have reaction at C positive. And you have 12 kilonewton negative, which is acting downwards. So if you just happen to see here in the diagram, RA positive, RC positive, 12 kilonewton negative. That is what is being written here. Therefore, if you rearrange the terms in this, you can write RA is equal to RC goes on the other side, becomes minus RC. Minus 12 goes on the other side, becomes plus 12. Therefore, RC, you have already calculated the value of RC, which is 9 kilonewton. So it is minus 9 plus 12, which is nothing but it is 3 kilonewton. It is 3 kilonewton positive. So your reaction at A is nothing but it is 3 kilonewton, which is denoted as VA here. VA. So it is nothing but it is reaction at A. It is reaction at A. Yes. So next, you have applied two equations of equilibriums now. Next is you are going to apply the third equation of equilibrium, that is sigma Fx is equal to 0. Sigma Fx is equal to 0, wherein you are going to add up algebraically all the horizontal reactions. You have only two horizontal forces here. One is the horizontal reaction at A, which is acting to the left, which means it is negative, and 8 kilonewton, which is positive. So it is RHA, which means that it is the horizontal reaction, which is with the negative sign, because it is acting leftwards. Next, you have a 8 kilonewton force. You have a 8 kilonewton force, which is acting rightwards. So it will be plus 8 is equal to 0. Or in simple terms, you can easily say that RHA is equal to 8. So RHA, transfer it to the other side. Therefore, you can write RHA is equal to 8 kilonewton. RHA is equal to 8 kilonewton. So that is what is being written here. HA is 8 kilonewton, which is acting to the left, which is acting to the left. So you have calculated with all the reactions. You have calculated with all the reactions, that is vertical reaction at A, vertical reaction at C, and also horizontal reaction at A. Now the next part, what they have done is, you since you have two reactions at A, they have combined them to form a single reaction. So you have a horizontal left and a vertical upwards reaction, horizontal left. So I'll just take both these. So you have a horizontal reaction, you have a vertical reaction, which is acting upwards, which is acting upwards. So next, the resultant of which will be obviously this. Yes. So this is your resultant. This is your resultant. So it is nothing but, it is nothing but, it is your resultant R. It is your resultant R. So this is your resultant R. Resultant R. Whereas what is this? It is nothing but it is your RHA. RHA. So it is RHA. RHA. Whereas you have one more vertical here, which is RA, what you can call RA. So by this diagram, you know that resultant R can be calculated as R is equal to square root of RHA square plus RHA square plus, you can write RVA. We shall write it as RVA. I'll just edit it. RVA. RVA. Okay. So it is RA. RA. So let this be RA. RA, which is written as 8 square plus 3 square, that is RHA square plus RVA square, which gives 8.54 kilonewton. Okay, and inclination theta of this resultant, you know it is tan inverse of sigma Fy by Fx. It is tan inverse of sigma Fy by Fx, right? So if you substitute that angle, you will get it with respect to horizontal. Now here what they have calculated, it is with respect to vertical. It is with respect to vertical. If I want it with respect to horizontal, it is tan theta is equal to RVA by RHA. Or if you want it with respect to vertical, it will be tan inverse of RHA by RVA. So it all depends on what angle you want. You want it with respect to horizontal or you want it with respect to vertical. So this is how actually you calculate the reaction. See, this is only 10% of analysis of truss. This is only 10% of analysis of truss. So the first part, which is very, very essential, that you are supposed to find out the reactions of the truss. Okay. Now we shall deal with one more problem wherein you are going to calculate the reaction only, you are going to calculate the reaction only, but the problems level of difficulty will be bit more, will be bit more. So this is another problem, this is another problem which is again a truss. You are supposed to find out reaction at A and reaction at E, reaction at A and reaction at E, and this is the loading condition of the truss. Again, you have only two loads acting at point B and at point D. So at point B you have a vertical load of intensity 2W. So it is intensity in terms of W, so you need not worry, it is just a term, it is just a term, it is 2W. Similarly at D you have a horizontal force with the intensity only W, only W. Okay, now if you can see this angle, so ABF or FDE, this angle here is 90 degrees. This angle here is 90 degrees. So this sign indicates that it is a 90 degrees. So these lines AB and BF, they are perpendicular to each other, making 90 degrees. Similarly, FD and DE making a 90 degree angle. So you're supposed to calculate the reactions at A and E. Reactions at A and E. Now again, I need to draw reactions here. I need to draw reactions here quickly. I'll draw the reactions. Okay. So I will take a vertical reaction at A. I will take a vertical reaction at E and I will take a horizontal reaction at A to the leftwards, to the leftwards. Okay, so these are the reaction, that is direction of reactions assumptions. Now I need to calculate for these reactions, I need to calculate for this reactions. So I know that reaction, let RA be reaction at A. When I say RA, it is combination of both horizontal and vertical. Okay, and RE, it is reaction at E. It is reaction at E. There is a printing mistake here. So it is reaction at E. So you're supposed to find out the reactions, and you know that you have three equations of equilibrium which you can make use of, make use of. But before that, the first thing, as we all know, that we are going to apply moment at point A, moment at point A. So let us count the number of forces. Let us count the number of forces. So how many forces are there total? So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 5 forces, 5 forces. And since you are applying moment at point A, A is the moment center, and these two forces become zero since they are passing through moment center. You are left with only three forces. You are left with only three forces. Amongst these three forces, two are vertical, one is horizontal. Two are vertical, one is horizontal. You shall start applying the moment. So if you can just see here, moment about A is equal to, so the first one, 2W, which is a vertical force. Distance to be multiplied is horizontal. Since the total distance between A and F is 4 meters, and only because this is right angle triangle, so this force which is acting, it will act exactly at the center. It will act exactly at the center. Thereby, this will be 2 meters and this will be 2 meters. It is only because this is 90 degrees, I repeat. It is only because this is 90 degrees. Similarly, here in this case also, the distance will be 2 meters on either sides. It will be 2 meters on either sides. Okay. Now, we need to start with the calculation of moment. Calculation of moment. So, two forces are passing through the moment center. Thereby, they become zero. You are left with three components. Let us start with applying the moments. So the first one, that is 2W, as I told, it is acting at a horizontal distance of 2 meters. It is causing a clockwise movement, thereby it is taken with the positive sign. So 2W into 2. Next, you have force W, which is horizontal. So distance to be multiplied is vertical distance. Now, in this case, I do not know what is vertical distance. I do not know actually what is vertical distance. It needs to be calculated. It needs to be calculated. Now, how do you calculate that? How do you calculate that? Now, for that, what we do is, I just take this right angle triangle. I'll take this right angle triangle, that is say D, E, G. Let this point be G. So if you take that right angle triangle, what happens actually is, since this angle is 45, you have 90 degrees, the other two angles will be 45 45. So this angle is 45 degrees. So this is 45 degrees, and I have told you that this distance is 2 meters. 2 meters, I want the vertical distance, that is x. So I can apply tan rule, that is tan 45 is opposite by adjacent. So tan 45 is equal to x divided by 2, where x is nothing but it is 2 into tan 45, which is 2 meters. So x is 2 meters only. X is 2 meters only. So you will substitute w into 2, because the line of action is horizontal. So you are multiplying the vertical distance, that is 2 meters, which is causing a clockwise rotation. And finally, you have a reaction at E, which is vertical and acting at a distance of 8 meters from A, causing an anti-clockwise movement. Thereby, you will write it as RE into 8. I hope this step is clear to everyone. So this is movement. Now, if you rearrange the terms in this equation, so this RE into 8 is taken on one side. It is 2W into 2 plus W into 2, which is 6W. Therefore, RE is equal to 6W divided by 8. So this 8 goes to the denominator. So RE is nothing but it is 0.75W. So you write the reactions in terms of W only, because the load also is given in terms of W. In the previous problem, it was kilonewton. So I wrote kilonewton as a unit. So here it is W. I'm going to use W as a unit here. Okay. Now, next thing is, I have sigma Fy, that is another equation of equilibrium which I'm supposed to apply. Now, how many total vertical forces we have? You have 1, 2, and 3. So two vertical reactions and one vertical force which is acting downwards with an intensity of 2W. So you have RVA, RE with positive sign and 2W with the negative sign. So if I apply sigma Fy, here, so I have RVA, I have RE, and I have both are positive because they are acting upwards, and I have 2W which is acting downwards. So it is 2W with negative sign, So next, RVA, if I rearrange the terms, I can write this as RVA is equal to RE with the negative sign, because it was positive, we have taken it on the other side, so it has become with the negative sign, and minus 2W, which was transferred to the other side, is with the positive sign. So RVA is minus RE plus 2W, wherein you know the value of RE already, you have calculated, that is 0.75W. So this will be equal to minus 0.75W plus 2W which is nothing but it will be 1.25 W. So RVA is 1.25 W. Similarly, you have another horizontal equation to be applied. So that is sigma fx. So sigma fx, you have how many horizontal forces in the diagram? You have only two horizontal forces. That is, one is horizontal reaction at A and W at D. So you have RHA, that is a horizontal reaction, okay, which is with the negative sign, plus you have, so RHA here is with the negative sign, plus you have a horizontal force which is acting to the right, which is W is equal to zero. Therefore, you can write that RHA is nothing but it is W, and it is acting to the left. So that is what they have calculated here. So in this problem, you have calculated finally all the three reactions. So basically, see, the reason why I took this solution here is, you may find that in different textbooks, they actually use different methods or different notations, or many such things actually happens, but you should be very clear with your basics. So whatever basics you have in your mind, you apply the same basics and you're going to solve for the unknowns. So this is how you're going to calculate the reactions in trusses